Hi everyone! Today I'm scrapbooking another photo from my friend's wedding. This is a picture of her bridal party. There were three bridesmaids and two bridesmen. And since there was a total of five of us, I thought I would use the number five from my cut apart sheet. I've been trying really hard to figure out pages that I could use these numbers in. And if I'm stretching every now and then on why I use the number, that will be the reason why. So, I had decided to use the back of the pink polka dot paper. It was a really, really difficult decision because I really liked the pink polka dotted paper. But the back of it was a white base with mint-colored, tiny confetti-like pattern. So I decided to use that instead. And I'm using my leftover scraps from other pages that I have made. One is that striped ombre blue sheet, which got cut up at funny angles. I still was able to use it on this layout as one of the layers to back my photos. And then the layer underneath that is the blue wood grain. And the layer under that is the other side of the blue wood grain, which is the blue floral. And I thought that was a really nice way to raise the photo and emphasize the picture. So now I am fussy cutting the five. I've been doing a lot of fussy cutting for the numbers because I don't like how they're squared. And the number five cutout had similar qualities of another cutout I had done in a previous page where the upper portion of the number did not have that pattern paper on it. So because I was fussy cutting the five, I had lots of leftover pattern paper and decided to add my own border back in so it looked like a complete five. And it was really easy because all I had to do was layer it right on top and just bring it out from underneath. And now it looks like there's a brown border around the entire five. At some point, my camera had stopped recording because I ran out of memory. But I realized and I was able to take some pieces off so that I can show you what I did. But some pieces were too glued on for me to actually remove because it would ruin the page if I took it off. So you didn't miss too much. I added a strip of ribbon at the top and added the strip of camera icons at the bottom to balance it out. And then I did cut off the branding strip from this piece of paper and added that below the camera strip. I had also added the Maggie Holmes sequin shapes as XOXO at the top. And I also had stamped the D right to the left of that. I just added brides with the sticky keys of October Afternoon, the teal and cream ones. And I'm putting the rest of my title down, which is Maids and Men. So it should read Brides, Maids and Men. Now I'm adding the number five, and I thought it'd be a good place to the left of the photo. And it reads better from the left to the right. So it'll read five bridesmaids and men instead of bridesmaids and men five. I'm adding some tags to the right side of the page. One of the tags I'm using as my journaling card. So it says, her bridal party was unconventional. It had both male and females, but that didn't matter as long as they all loved her. Then to balance out the gold sequins that's at the top, I decided to add this gold strip of star tape across the bottom on top of the camera icons. I'm gonna add a couple more things, like these enamel hearts. I decided to use a gray one on the number five, and then picked a blue one right by my journaling tag, and then a white one at the end of my title, right next to men on the bottom right. I also pulled my gray word stickers from Studio Calico and added fantastic to the number 5, so it could also read 5 fantastic bridesmaids and men. I also added 100% original right by my journaling tag, and then added the word true on top of men. And that's my page. So give me a thumbs up if you like this layout. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below. And I hope you have a crafty day.